Bon vendredi, tout le monde. It's been a difficult year. There's no other way to put it. But when times get tough, Canadians step up. I want to start today by thanking all Canadians for all their efforts in the fight against this global pandemic. You've made a lot of sacrifices over the past many months. You helped keep people safe. You helped save lives. Everything we did, small and big, in following public health orders, in making sure that ourselves and our loved ones and frontline workers were safe, made a difference. So thank you. On this eighth and final day of Hanukkah, and with only 1 week to go until Christmas, there are more than 75,000 active COVID-19 cases across the country. Deaths per capita are continuing to rise in many G7 countries, including Canada. Countries around the world continue to feel the pain of the second wave. We need to take this very seriously as numbers continue to head in the wrong direction. Our fight against this virus is not over, even as we're preparing to say goodbye and good riddance to 2020. It may be the holiday season, but we have to be more careful than ever. On Monday, vaccinations started for the most vulnerable and our frontline workers. Canada has secured agreements for up to 417,000 doses of COVID-19 vaccines ahead of schedule. This includes over 200,000 early doses of the Pfizer vaccine scheduled for next week and 168,000 doses of the Moderna vaccine before the end of December, pending Health Canada approval. I want to assure you again that any vaccine approved in Canada will be both safe and effective, and that health experts are making those decisions independently. In January, we'll be getting 125,000 doses of the Pfizer vaccine per week for a total of about 500,000 doses for the month. With the guaranteed millions of doses coming in 2021, every Canadian who wants a vaccine will get one, no matter where they live. This is the largest immunization campaign in our country's history, and I know that we have the right plan and the expertise that we need. But getting a vaccine in a week or in a month won't do you any good if you catch COVID-19 today. That's why we need to keep working to halt the spread of COVID-19. So please, continue to follow public health gathering guidelines. Avoid gatherings, practice social distancing, use the COVID Alert app, do the right thing for the most vulnerables, and think of being careful as a gift you can directly give your fellow Canadians, especially frontline workers who continue to step up every single day to keep us safe, to keep Canadians safe. Nous faisons beaucoup d'efforts pour nous assurer que les Canadiens aient accès à des vaccins sécuritaires et efficaces partout au pays. En même temps, nous travaillons aussi à nous procurer et à développer des traitements pour combattre la COVID-19 ainsi que d'autres infections virales. À ce sujet, j'annonce aujourd'hui un investissement de près de 9 millions de dollars par le biais du Centre national de recherche du Canada pour soutenir le développement de ces traitements. Cet investissement ira vers 4 compagnies pour leurs candidats de traitement contre la COVID-19, dont 2 à Montréal et 2 à Vancouver. Il est important de continuer à développer des solutions ici au Canada afin de lutter contre la COVID-19 et de se préparer pour d'autres éventuelles pandémies. C'est en travaillant avec les chercheurs, les scientifiques et les entreprises que nous allons y arriver. For many Canadians, the holidays are a time to cook good food and have a few extra pieces of dessert because, well, why not? But for far too many others, the reality is very different, especially during this pandemic. More than a third of Canadians who rely on food banks are children. That's unacceptable. In a country like Canada, no child should go hungry. In October, our government announced another $100 million under the Emergency Food Security Fund, doubling our investment from the spring. This morning, Minister Bibeau outlined the details of where that additional funding will go, including $30 million for food security in First Nations, Métis and Inuit communities. With these funds, food banks, local food organizations and Indigenous groups will be able to purchase and safely distribute food to help vulnerable people and communities. I want to say a special thank you to all the volunteers and workers at food organizations who've stepped up to help their fellow Canadians. I met many of you virtually in October, and I remember you sharing how you had to adapt really quickly when the pandemic hit. Thank you for your work, your time, your generosity, and for your commitment to answering the call for others in need. Je sais qu'on aurait tous espéré que la situation soit différente pour les fêtes. L'année a déjà été difficile et on vous demande encore de faire des efforts. Mais ce n'est pas le temps de lâcher. Il y a de l'espoir. On sait que les vaccins arrivent. On n'était pas sûr qu'il allait y avoir des vaccins contre la COVID-19 quand on en parlait il y a 6 mois. Mais nos chercheurs, nos scientifiques ont fait un travail incroyable ici au Canada et à travers le monde. Et on sait maintenant que cette pandémie a une fin et elle s'en vient. Mais elle n'est pas là encore. On a des millions de doses de réservées pour les Canadiens. Tout le monde va pouvoir être vacciné en 2021 au Canada. Mais avant d'y arriver, il va falloir qu'on passe ensemble un hiver difficile. Alors continuez de faire ce que nous faisons depuis des mois. De faire attention, d'éviter les rassemblements, de suivre les consignes de santé publique, de télécharger et d'utiliser l'application Alerte COVID, d'éviter des rassemblements. Noël ne sera pas pareil cette année, mais ça va être encore un moment, ça va quand même être un moment pour être là, virtuellement ou en personne pour les plus proches, pour réfléchir à cette année difficile, mais surtout réfléchir à comment on a pu passer à travers en tant que communauté, en tant que société, à être là les uns pour les autres, à faire le deuil de dizaines de milliers de Canadiens qu'on a perdus, mais de redoubler notre engagement pour avoir un Noël en 2021 encore meilleur et de loin meilleur que celui qu'on passe maintenant. On pourra le faire, mais il va falloir continuer à tenir bon. On peut offrir notre vigilance en cadeau aux travailleurs de la santé, ceux de la première ligne qui sont là pour nous protéger, pour continuer à travailler même pendant le temps des fêtes pour sauver des vies. Nous avons tous un devoir de les protéger et nous avons la capacité de le faire. Continuons de faire ce dont on a besoin et on va passer à travers. Since the beginning of this crisis, our government has done everything we can to protect you and your family. We've sent millions of pieces of PPE to the provinces and territories. We've created special programs for families and workers who needed it. We've supported small businesses so that they could stay open and hold on. We've presented historic measures to rebuild a more resilient economy that works for everyone. Now, I know that this won't be the kind of holiday season we might have hoped for. But that doesn't mean we can't feel hopeful about what comes next. This past year has had its challenges, but we faced them together. When this new virus started spreading, few people thought we'd have an approved and safe vaccine so quickly. So thank you to our scientists, to researchers, and to experts around the world who stepped up and worked incredibly hard. You've all done incredible things this year, and it's important that we keep supporting you in the work you do, and that we keep listening and trusting you in your expertise and your work to keep us all safe. The vaccination campaign has started. Millions of doses are already secured and will be coming in the coming months. We planned thoroughly. We're relying on advice from the best experts, and we're working with the provinces and territories to roll them out. Canada has the most vaccines secured per capita and the most diverse portfolio of vaccine options in the world. We're also doing our part to help developing countries get access to more tests, treatments, and vaccines so we can fight this pandemic everywhere. There are reasons to be hopeful for 2021. Just like through this spring, summer, and fall, we will continue to be there for you. We will have your back every step of the way. We will do, as a government, whatever it takes for as long as it takes to keep you safe and supported. We're coming into the final miles of this crisis, and we can't give up now. So stay home, stay safe, and we will get through this together. Joyeux Noël, tout le monde. Merry Christmas, happy holidays, and mostly, Happy New Year.